Hey, Fletcher here with a new series I'm calling Quick Cuts, where I just run down some quick tips on editings to help other content creators with their media creation process. You know, editing can be fun, can be a drag, but if you know some tips and tricks to just help smooth out the workflow, I feel like that really makes a big difference. So what I'd like to go through today is just some ins and outs edits. You know, not using the razor tool, not pointing and clicking and moving things back and forth, but setting it in, setting it out, and then doing a lift to just quickly make deletions and timeline edits with the least amount of clicks. I started learning editing with Premiere Pro, which is very click heavy. Then I learned Avid, which is very keystroke heavy. So moving a lot of the editing techniques I've learned from Avid and implementing them into Premiere, I think has really helped my workflow. And this is one I'd like to just quickly jump into the timeline behind me to show you. What I have is a stream from Saffron Olive from MTG Goldfish, which he graciously allowed me to use for this demonstration. And what we're going to be taking a look at is one game of MTG Arena and how to remove some gaps and speed the edit up to make a more dynamic, interesting game edit. So let's take a look. The gameplay is very turn-based. We can tell a lot of what we want to cut out based on looking at the waveforms, and we want to mostly cut on any kind of action and then not worry about jump cuts so much with the webcam. So here's a good edit point. Now, instead of getting the razor blade tool out and making an edit and then playing it and trying to find another good spot, make another edit, and then get a keystroke to get the pointer tool back, delete, and then ripple delete, it's a lot of steps. You know, the better way to do it,
there you go.
Set an in, jump ahead in time to a good game coming up. And what we did right there was set an in, set an out. We applied a extract, which takes that section out of the timeline and then shifts back any preceding stuff to the right of the playhead. Much faster than cutting, cutting, deleting, deleting, pointing, pointing, moving, moving. So if we apply that technique and do some fast editing, just looking for the waveforms, we can see cut here, we can cut here, we can cut here, here.
All right, we actually
cut that, jump ahead, find a gap here, cut. And then what I am neglecting to do at the moment is care about the gameplay or care about much of cutting on any kind of action or graphics. Now, that is something that you do want to pay attention to. However, I find that going back after you've made some edits to then move it around helps out quite a bit because this is pretty easy to do. And then you can watch it back as a viewer to see what you need to smooth out or leave in. So there you go. You know, really simple use of in and out to mark a selection that you want to take out of a timeline. You know, this concept can be applied to your digital audio workstation, your DAW that you're doing your podcast editing on. Definitely applies to Premiere Pro. It applies to really any other kind of non-linear editing software where you're using your ins and outs to set a spot that you're going to remove. It's very fast, much faster than doing a cut and moving individual items or making a selection and moving a bunch of items on your timeline. This just takes that chunk right out and it just makes you a better editor. So I definitely suggest giving it a try, putting the mouse down, getting that keyboard going and speeding your workflow up 110%. So I'm Fletcher. You can follow me at FunkDeLaFletch on Twitter. If you have an idea of something you'd like to see covered, please tweet at me and I will catch you on the next one. Thanks.